The Kid Chris Show.
There's a guy on another station in town called Kid Chris. He's the least entertaining, least funny person you ever heard. In fact, I've listened to Kid Chris. He's terrible.
Kid Chris.
Yeah! What's up? Yeah!
It is, man, what's it, Wednesday?
Yeah.
Already? Damn, dog.
Hump day.
Hey, Chaz Bono, off of Dancing with the Stars. I didn't watch it, but of course, what did I say when this was going to happen?
Did they boo?
Well, no. Now Chaz is lashing out, saying, that's because they don't like me.
No.
Well, they always make comments about what he looks like. They always make comments about his personality, and it's not about that. It's a dancing show.
So you think it's more personal?
Yes.
Of course.
Chaz, do you agree with that? You know, I've been called different animals by one of the judges several times.
Well, it was like watching a cute little penguin trying to be a big, menacing bird of prey.
I feel like that's disrespectful.
It's unnecessary, and it's rude, and it's bad taste.
Whatever.
Now, it's because he's fat.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that's why.
Chaz went off in an interview and started talking about how that, let's see, Chaz has been eliminated, that's because, oh, here we go. Now, because Chaz Bono was eliminated from Dancing with the Stars, the lesbian, gay, bisexual, LGBT thing, are going to start protesting.
Get out. Look, he made it this far. If they wanted him off, he would have been out the first day, the first show.
Yeah, he goes off and says that everybody... Let's see. I came on the show because I wanted to show America a different kind of man. I dedicate everything to the people out there like me, especially kids and teens who are struggling. That's fine. Good. But he's very upset about being he's very fed up about being compared to different animals by the judges. And then Bruno compared him to a penguin. Now he's pissed off. And he says, if you're an overweight woman in this competition losing weight, they love you. If you're an overweight guy trying to do this competition and getting in shape, they penalize you for it and call you a penguin.
What a jerk.
Yeah. So depending on, I don't know, what is it, ABC that owns Dancing with the Stars? Yeah. If that was radio, that show would be canceled.
Right. Actually, Chaz would own it, probably.
Yeah, exactly. They'd be canceled and told to go home, and your life is ruined. That's how it
Chaz
works.
Chaz is just being whiny. I mean, why can't he just be happy that, you know what I mean? Like, hey, you were on the show. You made it this far. You made some exposure for, you know, your people. Or
yeah, right.
You
exactly. Fine.
You know what I mean?
You did. The message got across.
Now everyone,
so in order for them to be happy and not protest, was Chaz, they're just supposed to hand
to
it over to him?
Yeah.
Hand it to him. Say, well, we got to give it to Chaz or else they're going to protest our advertisers
well,
and stuff.
Now what they're doing is forcing it down everybody's throat.
Yeah.
And now everyone's going to have a bad taste in their mouth about, you know, transgender people.
Yeah. And what about the burn guy? Nobody says anything about that guy. That guy's a national hero.
Right.
He got burned up in Iraq. So when he gets voted out, people are going to go, oh, man, that guy was a great dude. Now a bunch of military guys aren't going to go run in the street and go, this is bull crap.
Right. They're going to be like, he couldn't dance.
Listen, play the card you're dealt, bitches.
Now he tried to, and he switched. Chaz changed his hand.
Open Max. Chaz and Lacey on this sixth week of competition, the couple with the lowest overall combined total and therefore leaving right now is... Chaz and Lacey.
Oh.
If you're an overweight woman in this competition, losing weight, they love you. If you're an overweight guy trying to do this competition, you're getting in shape, they penalize you for it, call you a penguin. Bruno makes comments about me being cute and cuddly in this, every an Ewok with the Princess Leia and this, like I'm some... fat troll dancing with this beautiful woman every week, you know, and I'm sick of it.
What a bitch.
Look, bro, you are a fat troll. It's that simple.
Yeah.
Thomas and I are both fat trolls.
Yeah,
Alfie is a fat troll.
I don't look in the mirror and go, stunning.
Nah. Yeah, we sit there. That's the thing. We make jokes about each other all morning long. None of us goes and stomps out. Well, Thomas quit one time, but than that, you know, we usually man up. Puss. If you're going to be a dude, be a dude.
Yeah, right? You can't be a dude with
part
girl
of being
feelings.
Guys is breaking balls and having your balls broke. All right?
Chris,
that's right. There are none there. Constantine, what's up? What do you want?
What I want, well, Chris, I want to tell you how you look lovely on that poster, Chris.
Oh, the band billboard that went up. Yeah, the billboard is it's pretty sweet, Connie, and we're asking people to share that on Facebook. And in exchange, somebody at 735 is going to get the mega ticket.
Oh, wow, Chris.
Hey, Connie, didn't that poster make you feel horny?
Yeah, Chris made me horny when I set up.
All right, now I'm creeped out. Now, Connie, that's it. And Connie, by the way, what day is Thursday?
Tomorrow, Chris.
Yeah. He sounds like a car starting up. Constantine was a part of the Wolfpack, too, by the way. He made a call to QVC. This is classic.
Let's go back to the phones. Hi, this is Jill. You're on the air. Who is this, please?
Hi, my name is Constantine.
How are you?
I'm good, baby.
Great to have your company. How can I help you today?
Yeah, I was wondering if you can sniff my paint.
Bye-bye. So, dusty plum and turquoise, as you can see down at the bottom of our screen.
I want some dusty plums.
I never thought of Connie as an evil laugh.
I know.
You had like a wicked one at the end there, right?
Oh, man, listen, yeah, that's coming up at 7:35. We pick our winner for the mega ticket for today. And also at 9 o'clock, don't forget, we have row three.
Yeah.
Row three for WWE Raw. That's at 9 o'clock when we kick off 9, 2, and 5. You know, our segment, our new segment, I guess, is very popular. The segment we brought in as part of the segment we call Failed Bits. And this one was pulled out of the Failed Bit column.
This one's stuck.
Yeah, this one's stuck. And it's the What's Up interview, the latest.
Oh, yeah, it's time for our favorite segment of the show. What's Up?
We're on the phone with Heidi Fleiss. So, Heidi, you were a madam. You did drugs. You live in Nevada. What's up?
I guess I'm your, you don't make it in Hollywood unless you've been to rehab, so fit right in.
So you own a laundromat.
Yeah.
You have birds. You drove and left celebrity rehab.
What's up?
What's up?
You guys are funny.
So I heard you're looking for your meth dealer. I heard you used to bang dudes. You got big horse teeth. What's up?
That was America's favorite interview segment. What's up?
So rude.
Yeah. We have another one that's coming up and will debut next week. Another celebrity edition.
The Kid Chris Show.
Boyfriend's actually at work right now. Today's his birthday, and I want to call him and ask him to marry me.
Hello?
Hey, baby, what are you doing?
I'm working.
I just want to tell you happy birthday, but I got a question for you. Will you marry me?
Yeah.
Hey, wait a minute. No.
Yeah, you kind of fired up, man.
Yeah, your girl wants you to marry her.
Yeah, I know.
All right, well, listen.
My sweetheart.
Take
he's
it back.
Already miserable.
Yeah, he's already miserable. Here, you show him how it's done, Thomas, okay, all right? Here we go.
Who are you? Are you the girl?
I'll be LaFonda.
Okay.
LaFonda.
Hello?
Yeah. Why did it take you so long to answer the phone?
I forgot. You were calling me.
See, we're already fighting.
Hello?
Hey, baby, it's LaFonda.
Hey, what's going on?
Happy birthday.
Thanks.
Yeah. I'm wondering if you want to get married. I love you.
Yeah, I do. I want to marry you too, girl.
Woo!
Let's go have 10 kids.
See how it's done?
Oh, yeah.
Try it again. Here we go, LaFonda.
It's LaDonna.
Bring.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
Will you marry me?
Yeah, woo!
That was a clip from the Kid Chris archives just for you.
What you want, so what you want. It is the Kid Chris Show. It's Project 961. And in 1 hour, we will be picking, Thomas, the winner of our mega ticket. 5 big shows for you to go check out. Talk about... God, this is what a great tune. So I realize, Spock, I'm here to rock, y'all. here are the five big shows, all right? WWE Raw, Kid Rock live at Center Stage and sold out. Filthy Fifth birthday show. Our Filthy Fifth with Korn at Wild Bill's. Five Finger Death Punch. And then, let's see. Yeah, Five Finger Death Punch and Corey Taylor at Masquerade. So there's your one, two, three, four, five.
Yep.
Five big shows, one ticket. That person's going to get it at 7:35.
What person, Chris?
Well, thanks, guy. It's our intern, Skippy. He was asking what person will get that ticket, Thomas, at 7:35. Well, we randomly picked somebody who shares the Uncensored billboard up on our Project Family Facebook. Our billboard that we had done. All that hard work that went into it.
The greatest billboard ever.
I worked out for months and months to pose for that billboard. And
it shows. It paid off. It really did.
And it's up there right now because the billboard company said, no way. You know why? Because the guy who runs it's probably jealous.
Because you're ripped.
Just share that billboard, and we will randomly pick somebody coming up at 7:35 for the mega ticket.
Yeah, do it.
It's time.
It's time
for Kid Chris Prank Call.
It's time
for Kid Chris Prank Call.
It's time
for Kid Chris Prank Call.
Years ago, my friend Jack and I had an idea. Jack wanted to adopt some kids. It's
who
classic.
Doesn't? Who doesn't?
Adoption.
I was interested in looking into adoption. I have a kid, Chris, but I have enough love where I would like to, adopt another child.
Okay.
And I was wondering if you could give me information about that.
Can go to my website and look up.
Damn it, Chris.
Want.
You son of a bitch, shut the hell up. I am on the damn phone. I will throw you through the wall.
I'm sorry. Kids, huh? Anyway, go ahead and could you tell me more about that?
I've got a website that you can check out.
Uh-huh.
I hate you.
Damn it, you little sucker. Shut the hell up. I will throw you in the fireplace and burn you to a crispy cream pie. Now shut the hell up. Stop crying, you son of a bitch! Stop crying! I will give you something to cry about!
I hate you!
Sorry.
Is this a bad time for you?
No, it's a good time. You had a website I can go to?
Is your wife there?
No, I'm a single parent. What's the website?
It's www.
You little sucker, shut up! I am on the phone trying to adopt a child!
The Kid Chris Show.
Hey, this is Tracy Morgan. You need to call Kid Chris right now, bitch.
404-741-9696.
If you go to the Facebook page right now, if you go to kidchris.com, keyword Facebook, you'll see up there the Wolf Pack. The videos. This is a whole new level now.
Those are funny.
Our buddies, the Wolfpack, these are the dudes that get on radio shows and they just totally disrupt everything. Everything. Well, now they're videotaping themselves as they call in, and it's pretty funny because you can see them when they get cut off. You hear the show, and then when they get cut off, they're still talking usually.
Yeah, it's muted.
It's really funny. And we'll play back some of the best ones that we've heard in a long time yesterday, and I got some new ones too later. It's so good. So at about 7:05, we'll play back some of the great ones, some of the great new ones. And then also, those videos are up on online right now. And also, at 7:35, we'll be picking the winner of our mega ticket. That's right. The mega ticket is five big shows. One ticket, five big shows. This is something I think we're going to be doing once in a while. It's such a great contest. All you got to do is go up right now to the Project Family Facebook page. You'll see the billboard up there that we did.
Banned billboard.
It's banned by the billboard company. They wouldn't put it up around town. God, and we would have got, it would have been monstrous.
A lot of love from that.
A lot of love. So we're counting on you to share it. So all you got to do is click share and share that thing on your wall. We're trying to spread it virally. Make this bigger than what the billboards, more people will see that than the billboards right. That are actually up around town. And randomly at 7:35, we'll pick somebody and they'll get that mega ticket. And that's one ticket to five shows. Raw, WWE Raw, Kid Rock sold out at Center Stage, Five Finger Death Punch, An Evening with Corey Taylor, and our birthday show, the Filthy Fifth birthday show. With Korn at Wild Bill's. So that's not a bad prize. awesome prize if you think about it. So all you got to do is go to kidchris.com, keyword project, or keyword Facebook, and it'll take you there and you'll get all the info you need, okay? Now, listen, yesterday on the show, Alfie did some Alfie's little pop culture corner. He got involved with some of the things that are going on in the world as far as pop culture and had a few ha-has, some chuckles over it. And it turned out to be pretty pretty entertaining. I like watching Alfie perform, and you can watch his video, too. The video just went up right now, so you can check it out. So Alfie is here right now to, to do his stand-up or his monologue, right? Go ahead, Alfie.
All right. In a recent interview, Pee Wee Herman said that he wants to do Dancing with the Stars next season. Did you read about this, Chris? Yeah. Herman said that he's an avid dancer and he's been practicing the knuckle shuffle for years. Hello, 1991? Boom! Dropping it on you, ho!
All right.
So Chris Brown and Rihanna are both nominated for the Best Dance Performance at the Soul Train Awards this year. Did you hear about this, Thomas?
Yeah,
did you hear about
good.
This? Chris Brown said that he's excited to be nominated, but even more excited to beat Rihanna again. Boom! Rubbing it on you, ho! Alright, Starbucks, one of your favorite places to go to here, announced that it will be banning bakery products that contain trans fats. Did you hear about this, Chris?
Yeah.
It's crazy. Thomas from the Kid Chris Show is still safe, though, because they haven't banned chink fats yet. Boom! Dropping it on you, ho! A scientist say girls between the ages of 9 and 12 are at risk of getting fat. Did you hear about this, Thomas and Chris? That's crazy. To me, this scientific study is a waste anyhow because girls have always hit the wall at that age. Boom! Drop it on your host. And one more for that ass. A new poll shows that America is not ready for an Hispanic president just yet. Did you hear about this, Chris? This is insane. Further research shows that there's not enough time in the day to run the country and mow that huge White House lawn. Boom! Dropping it on your hoes!
Who can take a good joke?
Oh, Alfie.
There make it really bad.
Nice.
Put it all together and get Kid Chris mad, the Alfie man.
Got something to say, but the show ain't on? Call the Kid Chris Show after hours line at 404-870-5115.
We will be picking the winner for the mega ticket. Mega ticket, simple. It's five big shows coming to town. Our filthy fifth birthday party with Korn is one of them. Also, WWE Raw, Kid Rock, sold out at Center Stage, Five Finger Death Punch, and Corey Taylor. How do you get these tickets? Just share the band billboard up on KidChris.com, keyword Facebook. That's it. That's all I'm going to say about it, Thomas.
All right, that's it.
That's enough of that.
Uh-oh, I know that music.
Yeah, that music is the music for one group. These guys are more feared than that internet group, Anonymous. They are the Anonymous of radio. The Wolfpack, they call radio shows and they disrupt. And
hosts are quivering in their boots.
Yeah, exactly. Every time they crack the mic, they get nervous when they see the phone lines ringing.
They go, could it be a Wolfpacker?
The Wolfpack, these are three dudes, three or four guys, all right? Jimmy Jitsu, Zimmerman, and Sam FM. And these guys are, those are the core guys. And then you have Constantine, Bob Levy, and Thomas gets involved. I call in sometimes, but it's fun. And these guys now have taken it to the next level. They videotaped themselves so you can see them making the calls. It's hilarious. That's up on KidChris.com. Here's some of the ones that we debuted yesterday. Hilarious.
Go ahead, Jimmy. Vaccinations.
Yeah, well, for my job, they gave me recently a measles vaccination combined with a flu shot. And ever since then, you know, things have been definitely weird. I have food urges. I've been craving river pickles. And every time I listen to Thomas from the Kid Chris Show, I get a raging
Hey, all right, there you go. seriously, I knew it the minute this guy called. Mm-hmm. Rusty, welcome. You're on WRKO.
Are you against all vaccinations? What about, like, the HPV vaccine? If you had a daughter, would you want your daughter to get that?
No, I don't think so. No.
Okay, well, you know, if Kid Chris has gotten that, I wouldn't have anal warts right now.
You know, thanks for letting everybody know that you've got anal warts, and I feel badly for you. K Can't be comfortable. Can't be comfortable, my dear. Always count on this this guy. Oh, dear. Okay, where are we going? Let's go to Sam. Sam, welcome. You're on WRKO.
Well, I wanted to tell you that I am for vaccinations. Kid Chris got a hot injection. He
Chris,
had all
can you, seriously, you got to dump that.
Why
Chris,
be such
can
a
you
bitch?
Please dump this? Really? Why am I such a bitch? Why do you call a talk show? And why do you act like a total ass? Wait, somebody just asked me on the air. We're trying to have a conversation about vaccine. See, you must be pediatricians. Is that what it is? You don't like hearing a conversation like this? Is that what it is? You're scared? Why am I such a bitch? You guys, what are you, a couple? You like to call at the same time and talk about what you do to each other on the air, and you want everybody to hear it. Okay.
Okay.
That's awesome. Hearing her get fired up is the best part.
It is. It is
That's
so good. It is so good. Here's another one right here from the Wolfpack.
That's what you have to do. Steve, thanks for calling. Welcome to Newstalk 780 KOH.
You know, I heard you talking about Obama, but previously I heard your conversation with the gentleman prior to talking about how there's no jobs and how he worked in a, you know, he cleaned bathrooms while he went to college.
Right.
I commend that gentleman. I know kid Chris, he goes into the bathroom and he sets up a glory hole and he services other men. I think that's commendable. Come on.
Okay. Whatever your point was, thanks for wasting your time and ours. Doug, welcome to Newstalk 780.
Hey, good. I heard you say that you were a carpet cleaner.
I clean carpets, yes.
Yes.
Well, that's funny because I'm a carpet muncher, much like Kid Chris. You know that last caller said he cleaned toilets? You think he'd be wanting to clean my toilet? You know, the old dirt tube?
I don't know. I don't know. You'd have to call him if you want. Brian, welcome to Newstalk 780 KOH. Hello.
First, I would like to ask how you feel about Mitt Romney getting support from New Jersey Governor Chris Christie. And the other thing I would like to ask is if you think Kid Chris should reclaim the Intercontinental Championship, administer.
All right. We got a lot of loonies. Where are you getting all these loonies coming from, Phil? No, they're just making things up. That's all. All right. Let's go to Amy real quick. Hi, Amy. How are you?
I wanted to talk about Occupy Wall Street.
Yes.
Yes, I was wondering if you'd like to occupy my mouth because I'm a tranny.
Okay, all right. There's another loser. You got a lot of losers calling today, you see? And that guy's really messed up because posing as a woman. Tina, welcome to Newstalk 780 KOH. Hello.
I was wondering what your favorite part of the male penis is.
What an idiot.
Okay, Phil, we need to shut the phones down or something. I don't know what the problem is.
I'm sorry.
Tina's funny. Tina's funny. Those videos are up right now on kidchris.com. Check it out. How about news around the world in 30 seconds for you to get you up to date?
Some laughs with Jay Leno.
Have you been watching the GOP debates?
I'm going to wait until everybody's voted off the island.
Muammar Gaddafi is now buried.
3 weeks after his last essay on 60 Minutes, Andy Rooney being treated at a hospital.
Before he died, Michael Jackson asked a nurse for propofol.
The government advisory panel is now recommending that 11 and 12-year-old boys be vaccinated against HPV.
Children have been removed from a filthy trailer home where a 3-year-old boy and his 5-year-old brother were kept in a dog kennel.
Well, they shouldn't have talked back. That simple. Our phone number is 404-741-9696. You're going to need that a little bit later on because we're going to be announcing our winner for the ticket, the mega ticket at 7:35. So we're about 10 minutes away from that, Thomas.
I'm excited, Chris.
Yeah, me too. The mega ticket, 5 big shows, 1 ticket. That's at 7:35. And here, how about this, Thomas? I got something for you.
All right.
10 years ago in music. You ready for this?
I'm ready. I like this stuff.
All right. 10 years ago, number 5. This song was number 5.
It's been a while since I could.
Stained, of course. 10 years ago, that was number 5 on the Billboard charts. All right. Number 4.
Yeah.
This is Jagged.
Song.
Yeah, great. Number 3, Billboard chart. Mary J. Blige. Yeah. She's getting crunk with it. Family Affair is the name of that song. That's 10 years ago. That's number 3 on the Billboard
that
in the country.
Makes me feel old.
Alicia Keys was number two 10 years ago.
She's got a big dumper.
Yeah. I like this song better when it was called Adele. Right? I mean, really.
She was first.
Yeah. Making a joke, Thomas. Number one in the country 10 years ago. Jennifer Lopez, who's back now. That's what that Ja Rule.
You know what's funny is I remember you, when I actually first joined the show, I remember you playing this song.
Yeah, you were my intern. Yeah. I used to play this every hour. So imagine this show. We come out, we talk about shaving things and stuff, and then I go into songs like this.
Yeah.
Hey, we'll be back after Jennifer Lopez. We'll talk about shaving hooch.
Actually, do not like this song.
I'm sure my show ruined it for a lot of people. At the time, I had to play that music. Then let's do this, Thomas.
All right.
We'll throw you up to date. This is... the number five song according to iTunes download. Okay, this is now current.
It's the most beautiful time of the year.
Ah, Little Bieber. The street spreading
so much. Yes, Justin Bieber put out a Christmas song and it's already number five.
But I'm a man, he can do anything. He can take audios and farting and it'll be number one.
Look, he's got talent. I'm gonna throw that out there. I'm fine with it. Plus, this dude. For his girlfriend, like, rented out an entire theater just for him and his girl to watch a movie. Selena Gomez, right?
Yeah.
To watch a movie. That boxing movie with the robot boxing.
Robojocks, really?
Yeah.
Or whatever it's called, Real Steel.
Here's number four downloaded on iTunes.
I get she's got talent, but let's tone it back a little bit. I've heard every song a million times.
Here's a mix for you.
Yeah.
10 years ago. It's the same thing. It's the same damn thing.
Sometimes I love it. Sometimes it ends.
It is the same thing! Number three downloaded on iTunes.
Girl, you got it, girl, you got it.
Some guy named Drake.
Oh, Drake is huge.
Really?
Yeah, he writes for Lil Wayne. Lil Weezy.
Oh, so you're telling me Lil Wayne can't curse on his own? He has to have somebody write it for him?
He has to have somebody else write his profanity.
Man, I'm trying to figure out where I can put the word pussy in this.
Somebody help me out.
Yeah, get Drake on the phone.
Here's number two iTunes download. I work out when I walk in the spot. Yeah! No rock music on here, by the way. Because, you know, rock guys are still trying to figure out, how do I download this song?
Yeah,
what is iTunes? This is LMFAO.
It's a guy and his nephew.
I like this.
That's weird.
You know what this song needs?
Starting to move.
What happened to the song? Oh. So that's number two on iTunes.
You like them, guys.
This is number one. This is Rihanna.
Over her.
Yeah, I don't hear this song on the radio ever.
I've never heard this one at all. What song is it? What's it called?
It's called Beat My Face. No, it's called We Found Love.
Okay. That's the one where she's topless in the video.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I like that song. I really enjoy that song.
That's funny.
The winner of our mega ticket is coming up, all right? So hit us up on the website, kidchris.com, keyword Facebook. You'll see up there. You just got to share our band billboard, and then you're thrown into the qualifications. And we will randomly pick somebody coming up next, all right?
Oh, my God, is there nothing you don't say on this show?
Get me off of this submarine!
Surrounded by penis, I'd love the Kid Chris show!
Great. You guys are really sick.
The Kid Chris Show.
Kid Chris archives, y'all check it out.
Is this Dick Puffer?
This is Dick Puffer, yeah.
Can you hear?
Oh my God.
This is Peter.
Wait just a second. I'm going to let my wife hear.
Okay.
Hello?
Is this Miss Dick Puffer?
Yes. Yeah, Peter who?
Peter Puffer?
Where are you from?
From Pole Smoke, Michigan.
That was a clip from a Kid Chris archives just for you.
It's one of those shows. Yes, little Anthrax, old school. We have right now. We have the winner. The name. Thomas has a little info on our winner for our mega ticket that we do every morning this week. 7:35, we do it. Now this person qualified for the mega ticket, which is a ticket into five big shows coming to town. This person went up on KidChris.com, keyword Facebook, and saw the band Billboard. This person, the music's intense.
I know.
This person shared that billboard that was banned by the Billboard company, and we randomly picked this person. Thomas, what? Give us some info on this guy.
This person currently works at Wesley Apartment Homes. Also does some part-time gig at Home Depot. You might recognize this person in the accounting department at Georgia State University, as he is an alumni there.
Oh, it is. It is a he. It is he. Okay. Yeah.
This person is also from Duluth, Georgia, and he was born on August 7th. This person, Chris,
yes,
is Scott Nelson. That's right, Scott Nelson.
Come on down, Scott.
Come get your mega ticket, Scott.
Mega ticket. Scott is going to Raw. Kid Rock at Center Stage, sold out. Our filthy fifth birthday show at Corn at Wild Bill's. He's going to Five Finger Death Punch. He's going to have an evening with Corey Taylor at the Masquerade. Now, this ticket is going to get him some ass.
Yeah, because he's a mega winner now.
Yeah, that's if he's into that stuff.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Because, you know, nowadays some people aren't into that.
Let's not jump to conclusions.
Right, right. So, what's his name again?
Scott Nelson.
Scott's going, man. This is going to be good. So, make sure that when you see Scott, pat him on the back if you work with him at Home Depot. Or take one of those 2x4s and bash him over the back. Yeah, because he's going to be going to wrestling.
Yeah.
That's going to be a good time. So, and you'll probably be sitting with us.
What if he's listening and you're reading and reading all that stuff out? He goes, "That's me."
Well, that sounds like me.
I work there.
Now, wait a minute.
That's my birthday.
It's the Kid Chris Show. It's Project 961. We have at 7:53. Thomas has penned a new hit for everybody. This is exciting.
Better than this song.
Yeah. Oh, you think so? Huh?
That's right.
Boy, that's a challenge. So we'll see. At 7:53, Thomas will perform his new song for you, the Project family. We pulled our winner at 7:35 for the mega ticket, and he's over here on the phone. Scott!
Hey, what's going on?
Dude, congratulations, man.
That was pretty friggin' awesome.
Far into all the info that Thomas was given, all the stats, did you realize it was you?
When he said part-time at Home Depot.
Yes! Well, dude, you're going to be hanging out at all these shows, man. All the mega ticket, all those five big shows. That's awesome.
Hell yeah, that's awesome.
You, too, could qualify for this big ticket to see WWE Raw, Kid Rock at Center Stage, Filthy Fifth with Korn at Wild Bill's, Five Finger Death Punch, and an evening with Corey Taylor at Masquerade. Just go to kidchris.com, keyword Facebook. You'll see the band Billboard. Share it, and we randomly pick somebody that shares that thing at 7:35 every morning. It's very simple. You don't have to call a number. You don't have to do anything. And within seconds, we will hear Thomas's brand new song. Yeah, he's going to perform it here. We're going to videotape it. We'll put it right up on kidchris.com very soon. And also, don't forget, at 9 o'clock, we kick off Rock Out to Your Clock Out, 9, 2, and 5. We're giving away WWE Raw tickets. Now, that's pretty cool, but everybody who gets tickets gets to hang out with us on Monday morning and have breakfast with The Miz.
Yeah, that's cool.
I love The Miz.
Yeah, you do.
The Miz is one of my favorite wrestlers, so he's going to be here on Monday.
Hey, Miz, I was a wrestler. Is that what you're going to be saying to him?
No, I'm not going to be.
Hey, Miz, I was champ.
But Thomas, listen to this.
What's
okay?
that, Chris?
Quit mouthing off over there. What we're going to do is we are going to, at 9 o'clock, give away row 3 for WWE Raw. Row 3. That's going to be awesome. Are you fired up?
Yeah.
Oh! Yeah. Man, that guy is...
Sounds like it hurts.
I think that's actual audio from Macho Man when he crashed.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Bob Levy is on the phone.
Chris, how are you going to hang around with The Miz? I see the way you act around the wrestling when we go there.
No, you don't.
Yeah, Chris, you didn't even sit with your wife. You sat with me in the front row, and she sat in the back with Thomas.
That's true.
Yes. So there's no way you're going to handle being
you
around.
You ditched your wife.
Yeah, exactly. Dude, what guy, right now, every guy that's married listening is going, good for you.
No, they wanted to go see wrestlers. You were waiting for a wrestler to sweat on you is what you were doing.
Yeah, that's what I was
exactly.
doing.
Exactly. You, right, exactly. You had your face
you
had
got
your
it.
Face like a dog out the window. Yeah.
Right.
Sweat on
you're her. Absolutely right. And who was up there with me holding my hand?
Bob Levy.
Well, because I knew you were going to jump into the ring
yeah.
naked.
Yeah, that's right. I was going to jump into the ring naked. Right, Bob.
Let me tell you something.
Bob, how much do people pay to hear this kind of hilarity to go see you live somewhere?
A lot, Chris. Yeah. Okay? Yeah. I just made $6,000 in Vegas. Okay? Yeah. So shut your little mouth.
$6,000 in Vegas. $6,000 in Vegas. Good. So a guy who brags about what he made somewhere, that's somebody who didn't make that much money.
I'll show you the check. Listen to me, little fella. I know you're all cranky.
Well,
okay?
Bob, let me ask you this: who were you in Vegas with?
Me, hey. I headline. Okay, I'm
sure like, you
you've
did.
Been away a little while.
Sure you did. Sure you
you've
did.
Been
Look,
okay?
Sometimes... How many other clowns from other shows were on that list with you?
There was one comedian on the show with me that I didn't even know, okay?
I'll be honest. Bob makes a good check for performing at buffets. You know what I mean? In Vegas? That's good money, man.
Yeah,
I mean,
who,
people
who
get jerks in
money
seconds.
Who
loses a lot of... Yeah, that's pretty funny. Hey, so that's okay. That's a good one.
Okay, so that's worth $6,000.
That's not worth $6,000.
Thomas was there. He sees the gleam in your eyes. Even when the security guard Tina's walking down, he looks in your eyes and he goes,
Bob,
oh,
we gotta
no,
go.
Not you.
Yeah, that's right. That's what he does. He says, oh no, not you. Bob,
yeah, because what do? You have your gay
Bob,
signs
we gotta
up
go.
To the, you know what you do. You put the gay signs up so the wrestlers
that's
look
right.
at you.
I have gay signs, right.
You do.
Okay.
You had a sign Bob, that said
have sex with me. That's what it said. Right.
You guys have been fighting like a couple.
I'm not fighting with him. I'm just agreeing.
Like a little schoolgirl. Right. You got a schoolgirl crush.
I
want to know when this conversation gets funny.
When you leave the room, you want to.
We got to pay him $6,000 for that.
I don't get paid to be funny, damn it.
Hey, Bob, I forgot to tell you something. He knew it was coming. Enough of that stuff. People want to hear Thomas's new song.
Let's do it.
Thomas has made songs in the past where he sings, and just to get the audience to know, you know, we have billboards up all around town. We have our other one that's a band that's going viral across America, mm-hmm. across the world. And, you know, people know me. I put myself out there. I'm naked on a billboard, for Christ's sake. I have billboards all over Atlanta, so you know me, Kid Chris. But do you know Thomas?
Do you know me?
Do you know Thomas?
Do you care to know me? Do you want to get to know me?
Thomas.
If you want to get to know Thomas, he penned a hit for you, and he's going to perform it right now. We're going to videotape it so you can watch it. You ready, Thomas?
Let's do it.
This is going to be a smash. I can already feel it. Nice.
Yeah. Can't you see? I'm not Hawaiian. People think, they think I'm lying. They don't know that I'm from Tokyo. Yeah. I drive a Honda, a white prelude. People think, they think I'm rude. They don't know that I'm an angry Asian. I'm really short and my head is big and round. I want lovers from swingers around town. Me love you long, long time.
Yeah, Thomas! Oh, yeah!
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Face-looking chicks make my egg roll rise. They get me so horny. People wonder why I don't have slanted eyes. Cause I'm a half Asian man, so you know I'm Japtastic.
Yes!
I'm from a
a foreign land, so you know I'm Japtastic. I'm a half Asian man, so you know I'm Japtastic.
Yeah. You like that?
Wow.
That's nuts, right?
Yeah, put that on the pop stations.
Yeah, that's right.
Do it
Let's
now.
Do it. Number one with a bullet.
You hear that?
Yeah.
It's that station next door to us.
It's the essays next
door.
Yeah,
the essays next door.
The essays next door.
They're going to curse at us in whatever language.
That's not Chinese. That's not funny, man.
They're making fun of Thomas now. Oh, it's racist. Wow. Did you hear that? That's rude. Listen, man, the video of Thomas performing his new song is up right now on KidKris.com.
See, I think that one's, I like that one. That was a hit right there.
You think so, huh?
Yeah.
No, we'll leave it up to the listeners to decide that, Thomas. I disagree. I think you've lost a step.
I think you're right.
Hey, listen, I got news around the world for you. Get you up to date right now in 30 seconds.
Some laughs with Jay Leno.
Have you been watching the GOP debates?
I'm going to wait until everybody's voted off the island.
Muammar Gaddafi is now buried.
3 weeks after his last essay on 60 Minutes, Andy Rooney being treated at a hospital.
Before he died, Michael Jackson asked a nurse for propofol.
The government advisory panel is now recommending that 11 and 12-year-old boys be vaccinated against HPV.
Children have been removed from a filthy trailer home where a 3-year-old boy and his 5-year-old brother were kept in a dog kennel.
Damn, that's not a way to live. looking right here on the Facebook, watching people's comments. Some people enjoy your song, Thomas. They
Do
think,
they really?
They think it was the best one. So there you go.
All right.
I'm good with that.
People have spoken.
Also up there, you'll see the billboard. I posted up there again, so it's on the top of the wall. If you go to KidKris.com, keyword Facebook, the band billboard. Just share that, and then you are in the running for the mega ticket that we will give away again at 7:35 tomorrow morning. Wolfpacker. Chris Zimmerman on the phone.
Hey, do you still have that Randy Savage doll you used to bring in the tub with you?
I don't have a... No.
What'd you do with it?
I don't have a Randy... Actually, Bob Levy, who called earlier, is the guy that used to...
Yeah, he had the wrestling
dolls.
He's
the one that had a tub and would play with wrestling dolls in the tub. And not as a kid. It was during his first marriage. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
That's the truth. And if Bob Levy was a man, he would call in and admit that. But he's not a man.
Don't give him a license to call in again.
That's true. I'll just speak for him.
Yeah.
And also, hey, Chris Zimmerman, who's on the phone, he's part of the Wolfpack, he went out to Occupy San Jose and bothered those people out there. And yesterday, 50 people got arrested at the Occupy Atlanta.
Yeah.
But, that's what they want. But now it's over. See you later.
Occupy Oakland had tear gas and pepper spray bombs going into the crowd.
See, that would have been fun to watch.
I know. They should just take a bulldozer through all these people. The Occupy jerk-offs.
Losers.
Yeah. Yeah, it was funny, though, when Chris went down there and messed with all those people down there at Occupy San Jose, because those guys were just, they were, talk about dopes, complete dopes. Here's an example of one of them.
Tell us what you're here for.
I came down to show my support for the Occupy San Jose movement.
How did you get here today?
By car, and then I walked 5 or 6 blocks.
Okay, so a vehicle, a corporate entity.
Not a corporate entity, just a vehicle.
How much money must someone make before they are part of the 1%?
$500,000 and above. And that includes the people who make $10 million a year. So that 1%, they're big bucks. They're not just people that get paid well. They're very big bucks.
Do you own a home?
I do.
Would you be willing to surrender your home to the homeless so that things would be more fair?
No, that's not capitalism. Sorry. I'm a capitalist.
Okay. And who is the...
I'm a capitalist supporting a socialist movement.
Right.
The current vice president?
Does anyone...
No. Okay. And who is the current vice president?
Does anyone know who the current... Does anyone know any vice president? I don't care what year it is.
And how many senators are there in Congress?
Am I doing the Congress and the House of 52? Last time I looked.
Okay. And what is the capital of Atlanta?
Wow. I don't even know if it is Atlanta. It probably isn't.
What are you more afraid of, gay marriage or black people?
It's gay black people that I'm really worried about.
And can you describe a taint for me?
A taint?
Yeah.
Well, let's face it. If it ain't one thing and it ain't the other, it's a taint.
An Occupy or hair pie?
Hair pie.
Okay. Thank you.
See, I agree with a few of those. Okay. Like the taint one. Well, listen, Chris Zimmerman, I have new Wolfpack tapes that you guys gave us. You know, yesterday. What do you think the biggest one yesterday was?
The biggest one yesterday, I think, was the Bill Manders one.
Yeah.
I don't know what I said to get all these calls, but let's find out. And Sam, we'll start with you.
I wanted to talk about Obama apologizing for dropping the A-bomb that ended World War II.
Right.
Are we apologizing for wiping out all of King Chris's favorite Asian rub and tugs?
Bobby.
I think it's interesting that a lot of people feel that Obama never should have apologized to Japan, when I think he should have, right? America, you know, we stole Hawaii from Japan, and they had every right to bomb us at Pearl Harbor, right? I think that the people who think Obama shouldn't have apologized should really, you know, apologize to Kid Chris for dragging Thomas's mail trail down my face, right? What do you think about that?
What the hell's going on today?
Do you even want to take another call? Like,
you know what? This is organized. Right. This is not.
Yeah, I know. This
is not spontaneous. This is bull stuff.
They're coming after you, Greg.
Yeah, I'm just scared poopless here. Michelle.
Hello.
Hello.
I'd like to see if you guys like to occupy my meat wallet.
I've never seen anything like this. This is hilarious.
This is definitely organized. Like, if I see Chad, I might, you know.
The rest of you may as well hang up now. We're not taking any more calls today.
So that was, the best one from yesterday. I've got brand new stuff that we'll do in a few minutes. And also, we are 45 minutes away from giving away
Row 4.
Row 4. Is that what it is? Row 4?
No,
row
3.
Three for Monday Night Raw. Let's do this. It is the Kid Chris Show.
Kid Chris.
Yeah. Thanks. I'm reading this thing here. Michael Lohan, Lindsay Lohan's father, was arrested because he got a little rough with his girl because she wouldn't give him mouth hugs.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he got arrested for it.
I mean, after you say please and they say no, I think roughing up is
yeah, right.
Change of mind.
And why would you want to piss off a chick by getting into a fight with her? And then I wouldn't want her anywhere near that when she's mad. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's her right there. Yeah. Phone number is 404-741-9696. We got coming up at 9 o'clock. We'll get Allie in here, and we'll pick our winner for Row 3 for Monday Night Raw. Okay? And then also, let me tell you who's coming up. Well, spread across the rest of this week and next. Zach Wilde is going to call in and talk to us. He's on the new William Shatner album, and he's a friend of the show. Also, Sammy Hagar, again, who's a friend of the show. We got a lot of celebrity friends. Clint Howard, who is Ron Howard's brother.
Right.
You know this dude.
Yeah, if you saw him, you know exactly who he is.
Exactly. He's the guy. Man, what was he famous?
He's the bald guy.
Yeah, the little bald guy. God, you know, he's one of those dudes that everybody knows.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's been in
a
million
in every movie.
Yeah.
And then also Ron Paul. You know, he's one of those dudes that runs for president every year and gets blown out, but has a lot of followers. That's what I don't understand. And Octomom. Now, Octomom, whenever she comes on, she's a hot mess. So, and for some reason, she likes us. So she continues to call and to get a hold of us to promote something. So this time, we're going to end our relationship with her.
That's it?
Because I'm over her. I'm sick of it. And I'll tell you why. She doesn't talk dirty.
No.
I want her, you know what I mean?
She's always like on an awful phone when she calls us, too.
Yeah, so we'll deal with her. That's probably going to be tomorrow that she calls in and talks to us. So that'll be pretty cool. Yeah, so tune in tomorrow as we destroy a relationship. Wolfpack, I teased this a little while ago. They got brand new tapes. Calling radio shows and just disrupting these guys. These guys just piles and piles of tapes they send in, and they're all good. And now they're videotaping it and putting it up. You can see that up on
Kid. That's a whole new element to it.
You watch them do these calls. KidChris.com, keyword Facebook.
Hi, Bill.
Hey, how are you, Ron?
Good.
Yeah, there was some guy with a farm that had a bunch of wolves and tigers and bears that apparently he like set them all free and then he killed himself.
Yeah, you've been listening to our newscast.
Yeah, I mean, apparently the guy's name was Kid Chris, and he's got this radio show in Atlanta on Project 961, and he's got this wolf pack, and the wolf pack just, they got free, and they're just causing terror all over the place.
I never knew that. I mean, I knew the animals were loose. I didn't know it was a radio personality who had
The guy's name is Kid Chris. And all these animals run around and they give top shelf to each other and they do bukkake on each other. It's just a real mess. It's disgusting. What do you think about that?
No wonder Stefan played that song Jungle Love. A lot of things going on out there with those animals, Bill.
Yeah.
Appreciate the call, my man.
All right.
Jimmy, you're up next.
Funny, I want to follow that. Did that guy say that guy was out of Atlanta, Georgia?
Yeah.
Well, it's funny. Do you remember the other, the bear that got loose from the Project 961 exhibit there? It wasn't that long ago, and they had the billboards up of him, and I guess he had a two-person act. I think it was Kid Chris the Bear and Thomas the Clown. They did a They were like a gay circus act. And,
a gay circus act?
A gay circus act, the two of them. Yeah, they would, they would do the top shelf. They would wear their clown shoes, all kinds of things. They would stuff stuff in a mud cutter. It was a crazy thing. Don't know if, I know it's from Atlanta, and I don't know if the listeners would know about that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm from Georgia, but they didn't do things like that when I was growing up.
No, things have changed over there these days.
Yeah, I agree. Thanks for the call, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Okay, Sam's up next. What's up, Sam?
I wanted to talk about the wolves.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Do you think that they hump each other?
Sam, let me explain something to you guys. Don't be calling this show and trying to sneak dirty stuff in like that. Sam, if you're listening, your mama ought to wash your mouth out with soap.
Yeah. Hey, listen, don't call here Sam and do that. But the other guys were completely over the top. Yeah. And he's like, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, that's fine.
He's just mad because he got taken for a ride the whole time.
That is hilarious. Here's another one from the Wolf Pack, all right?
Hey, Steve.
Steve!
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, everything in the world is raining. Crazy cats and dogs living together, trains running into each other. Oh, my God. Airplanes crashing. Go ahead.
I got to tell you what, you are the biggest jerk off I've ever listened to in my whole life. Why don't you eat a bullet quickly? Can you do me a favor? Huh? You ass clown. You still giggling about it?
Yeah, I'm laughing at you, you dumbass.
Dick face.
Oh, my God. You can't talk like that on the air. Get his number. Oh, God. Yeah. There's no reason to call and say that stupid stuff. Get that number online, too. You got it?
Would you be surprised, New York?
No. We got to fill out paperwork again. Hey, line three, go ahead.
Hey, wanted to get your take on the Paul McCartney wedding.
Well, he's an old guy who doesn't want to live alone, and he got married to a younger woman, and hopefully it'll work out, but, you know.
Do you think he boned her real hard?
Okay, what is going on here?
Okay.
Is that the same guy?
No, but we're done for a while. Don't you think?
Yeah. Band on the run. Hey, Rocky D, here, line five, go ahead.
Hey, I want to talk about this shooting at the CVS on Saturday.
Rocky, go ahead.
I don't understand why, I mean, I guess the guy needed money or whatever, but why couldn't he have demonstrated peacefully like this Occupy movement?
I don't know what he was mad about. What was the deal?
I mean, I would like to occupy Kid Chris's mouth for one.
Okay, what?
Well, no, we're all done with breaks, so I don't know.
Mac, are you there?
Well, what I think is that you guys were talking earlier about tossing Kid Chris's salad. I wanted to get more about that.
Oh, come on. There you go. Would you guys stop doing that? Get that number, too. Get that number, too.
Oh, it's one of those shows. I get it
that
now.
That guy was a clown, man. He deserved every bit of that.
One more Wolfpack tape.
Rusty from New Berlin, you're on 620 WTMJ.
Yeah, until the baby breathes its first breath, it's not a baby, it's a fetus.
Okay.
Right, otherwise I'd be guilty of millions of counts of murder by every time I dropped Kid Chris's nut butter on the ground.
Oh, my God.
Let's go to Steve from the East Side, you're on 620 WTMJ.
Hey, what's going on, dick face?
Why are these people getting through? This is we got classic people today. What?
Wow. Oh, that's the latest from the Wolfpack. They videotaped those. They put them up online. A second ago, we were talking about Clint Howard. Heather, real quick, what about Clint Howard?
I just want to note that everybody, if they're having a hard time recognizing him, the most easiest recognized role he was in was all the Austin Powers movies when they said they see a big dick or a big Johnson.
Okay. Big Johnson. So what was his character in that? It was Big Johnson?
He was the guy that said it. He was working like in NASA.
Okay.
And he would see the big satellite that looked like a big.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so that's Clint Howard. He's going to be coming on the show, I guess. I don't know. Now, if nobody knows who he is, I don't want to put him on. This is Thomas's new song. He performed at 7:53 this morning. The video is up on KidChris.com.
Can't you see? I'm not Hawaiian. People think, they think I'm lying. They don't know that I'm from Tokyo. I drive a Honda,
a white prelude.
People think, they think I'm rude. They don't know that I'm an angry Asian. I'm really short and my head is big and round. I want lovers from swingers around town. Me love you long, long time.
Yeah, Thomas! Oh, yeah!
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Face-looking chicks make my egg roll rise.
Right on.
They get me so horny. People wonder why I don't have slanted eyes. Cause I'm a half Asian man, so you know I'm Jap-tastic.
Yes!
I'm from a foreign land, so you know I'm Jap-tastic. Yes! I'm a half Asian man, so you know I'm Jap-tastic.
Yes! There you go. You can watch him perform that up on KidChris.com. That's with two D's. Wendy from the Wolfpack, the Wolfpack leader. Hello, Wendy.
Hey.
It's so great to talk to you. Are you getting excited? Mm-hmm. We're just around the corner from Halloween.
Uh-huh, it's me.
No, I know you're Wendy, but we're just... Thomas, please.
I'm sorry.
We're around the corner from Halloween.
I've got a problem.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
I got a bad case of the flu.
Oh, you're sick today?
Yes.
Oh, I can hear the sniffle.
You okay?
Well, I went outside and got this horrible flu.
So you went outside and caught it? You didn't I think people get that stuff at school. You probably got sick at school.
Well, I can't tell you about my school.
Why?
Because if I want to tell you, it would be a secret.
Oh, okay. No, but I'm saying you probably got sick from somebody at school.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. But I think you'll get over it. Like, when did you first start getting sick?
Well, one time I saw this chipmunk outside.
Yeah. Wendy, Wolfpack Wendy is one of our first friends here when we moved here to Atlanta, and she started calling us every day, and we really love Wendy, especially because, you know, she's awesome, and she lives with awesome-tism, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Wendy, are you going to be able to go trick-or-treating then, or what?
Well, my mom and I like to carve pumpkins.
Right,
right.
So there you go.
That makes sense.
All right. Now, do you think last time we talked to you, we were talking to you, you talked about how scared you were of Jigsaw, and then he came into the studio and talked to you. Do you think maybe that's how you got the flu?
Exactly.
Oh. Right. So that's how you got it?
Uh-huh.
Wow. So I think you're going to have to somehow defeat him.
Oh. Uh-huh. You're going to have to battle Jigsaw.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, as a matter of fact, uh-oh.
Hello, Wendy.
Hey.
It's Jigsaw from the Saw movies.
Are you still there?
Yes, I'm here. It's Jigsaw.
Hey, what's up?
So, it looks like my little plan worked.
It did?
Yes, you have the flu now.
I know.
And it's from me.
The Miz?
No, me, Jigsaw.
Oh, yeah.
The hell
I recognize you wearing a tuxedo.
Yes, that's right. In the movies. Now, quit confusing me.
Oh.
This is
I gotta tell you something, Jigsaw.
Excuse me, don't interrupt.
I got this horrible flu.
I know, I gave it to you.
Mm-hmm.
That's only one part of my game.
What's the next part, Jigsaw?
I have yet to figure that out.
Oh.
I think the next part is, I'm gonna make you throw up.
Well, that's kind of ironic. Sometimes I'm drinking green tea.
That's right. I knew that.
Mm-hmm.
Next, I'm going to make you drink water.
Water? Salt water or regular water?
Regular water.
Cold or hot?
Why do you need to know all this?
Well, sometimes I drink cold water. I could put cold ice in it.
Why do you got to be all confusing?
I think she's going to be... Wendy, you're going to be Jigsaw.
And who are you? What's with your big head?
What?
Well, sometimes hot water gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Me too.
Yeah, sometimes.
Do you like to take a bath?
Well, sometimes I take a nice warm shower.
Really? I like to take... I'm Jigsaw, and I like to take a bath with a rubber ducky.
Are you sure?
I'm positive. I'm there. Can you see?
You're not trying to pull another trick on me.
I am.
You gotta be careful, Wendy.
I think, Wendy.
I am.
Wendy.
I'm really smart. I have to be more careful with Jigsaw.
Yeah.
You know what makes me go away? What makes me scared?
What, you mean the Silver Cross?
No, when you sing the SpongeBob SquarePants theme.
Oh, you mean you're afraid of him?
I'm afraid of him. If you sang his song, that would scare me away.
Oh, don't worry. He's the king of karate. Trust me, he does.
So if you sang his song, I would go away.
Oh, don't worry. He laughs all the time.
Go ahead and sing. Sing, Wendy. No, sing the song, the SpongeBob song.
SpongeBob SquarePants.
No. No.
Keep going, Wendy.
No.
It's over. It's over. It's over.
No. Keep singing.
Well, it's not a long song.
Wendy, we got to go. Thanks for calling, all right?
Wait, before I hang up, I need to request a song.
Okay.
6 a.m. Life is beautiful.
You got it.